Hailing all the way from Ladysmith in KZN, Nosipho Khuzekwayo, better known by her stage name, New Sam, is an acclaimed poet known for her touching on issues that will help inspire and empower women all over our great nation. New Sam, welcome to The Loft.
Thank you for having me. Thank you very much.
I'm already loving the play on Nosipho, new, everything is new and fresh about you, girl. But if I were to find out about baby Nosipho, growing up in Ladysmith.
Oh my God. I've always felt like I was older than I was. So I always used to fight people and be like, yo, I'm old. I see things that y'all don't see.
Oh no.
Yeah, I think that was my problem.
What do you think it was about that? Because, you know, I do believe sometimes children just know. Yeah. You know, sometimes if you're an intuitive, feeling child, yeah. There is a saying literally that says, you know, you're wiser beyond your years. Yeah. So do you think that that was that, or you were just very defiant, rebellious, argumentative? Because there is both sides of that coin.
Nah, I just think it was the brains. I always just felt like the things that I do sometimes, people are just like, it's a kid. I always felt like I'm smart.
Oh, wow, girl.
I'm smarter than other kids that are my age. So I always try to challenge people older than me. Mm. I always, not that I'm being super, like, not something like that. But then things that I'd say, I try to fight it with you. Hear me. I'm not a kid. Hear me. I'm trying to say something.
I love that. Wow. Yeah. Okay, I'm already having this picture of baby Nosipho out there just fighting all the older bullies. But I mean, when it comes to family, you've touched on the fact that you do respect your elders at the end of the day. Yeah. You do know, you know, culturally within us Africans, we have to always look up before we decide to say or come sideways. Yeah. So tell me about what family means to you.
Family is everything. I wouldn't say family is just blood, relatives, or anything like that. Because, like I said, Uti, growing up, I've had to grow myself because I've changed my locations every now and then. So the people that I've met along the way, they became my family because they cared. So I guess that's what it's about to me. It's about a person trying to care of another person. Mm. Doesn't have to be a blood relative or anything like that. As long as we get each other and we're trying to take care of one another, man.
Mutual respect and love is what it's all about, supporting each other, essentially. So tell me about your journey within music, poetry, and your writing.
Okay, I started writing at a very young age. I always used to write, had a music book. You know, back then we used to do our music book.
You write your lyrics.
Just stupid songs. And then as I grew up, I started, like, writing poetry, getting more interested in writing poetry, the rhymes and all that. And as I moved to high school, I met a friend who was doing spoken word. I mean, I was just a writer, and then she used to recite. And I was like, damn. So people, when they recite, you can actually hear what they are saying. Because sometimes there are words, you have a word that has like three type of meanings, and it depends on how you pronounce it. Then a person can hear what you're trying to say using that word. Yeah. But when you write, a person can just read the way that they want to read.
And interpret it in their own way. That's so interesting that you say that, because we can relate. You know, when you're sending a text message, people always say it can be interpreted in whatever way you want.
Yeah.
But there's something about being able to hear the words come out that shifts the meaning.
When I saw her perform and recite, I was like, I'm doing that because I want people to actually get what I'm trying to say. I want them to feel what I'm trying to say. So I started reciting, and I recited with her. We morning assembly at school in, and it was a huge crowd because it was a big school. So from there, I just knew. And 2018, then Sjava discovered me. Then we went to music then, putting it in music,
I love that. So I want to get a taste of this written word. I want you to perform something for me, a piece that you specifically, specially wrote for us. And I think that what's so beautiful about this, it's a very inspiring, empowering poem all about the ladies.
Yeah. It's not just for the ladies, though, you know. I'm just trying to talk to people, you know, about... I've realized how most of us, we always depend on being loved by someone else, and we never focus on loving ourselves first. And we always just lean on, and you just want someone to bring that life into you. But it doesn't have to be like that, you know. So I wrote it because I feel like we can love ourselves more than we actually do. Like, there's something, because you know what you deserve. Why not give it to yourself, you know?
I love that.
So, yeah.
Take it away, Nosipho.
Okay, it goes like this. Mntanami uyabona kulo mhlaba bayokuthanda mhla wahamba. Bayokuthanda usumathamba amhlophe usumunye nomhlaba. Nasemngcwabeni wakho bayoqamba amanga izitha ziyobe sikhala. Mhla washiya lo mhlaba bayokubiza ngawo wonke amahla amagama. Inhloso yami ukukutshela ukuthi ungancingi ukuthandwa. Uthanda imvamisa abasitha ngalizono namanga. Ungakhali. Okokuqala umuntu uhlulwa yena ukuzithanda. Inhliziyo yakho uyoyinakekela kanjani eyakhe imqaka. Mntanami injabula kusiya umuntu musukudlala. Uyabona empilweni into yokusiza ukuzibeka kuqala. Umuntu uyokujikela ubothemba itshe kuqala. Vumela umoya wakho uthobeke, uvumela umqondo uqonde iqinise izimo uzamukele. Uvula amehlo. Uma sekungamele ubambelele udedele. Inhliziyo yakho isiyodla uthando lonke liphelele.
Thank you. I was caught between do I clap, do I click? I've got goosebumps all over my body. Wow. New Sam, a true talent when it comes to using vernac within your rhymes. I mean, it's all about keeping it local, lekker, proudly South African, and celebrating ulwimi lwethu. Thank you so much for coming through, Nosipho. But we do have more from her coming up, where we're going to have an incredible performance of a song of hers titled Vuyo Lwethu.